up for the basic alignment and the internal connections, the bandhas, or the centering, or the channels, or the gateways. There's different ways you can look at it. But we want to engage the internal body. We lift in and up through the perineum or through the pelvic floor. We engage through the front body. And then we bring our awareness to the cervical spine, yes. And for some of us, we have a tendency of this posture. So with that, when you come into the practice, you have that kind of awareness. You just draw the skull back a little bit more. So all of that, but the chin won't go up. It stays level. Pause here, and perhaps you can come to the center of the mat, and then just gently shift forward and back as you start to feel the grounding through the legs. We're creating in the body, yes, good, oppositional energy. So the low body is grounding, and then the upper body is engaged and lengthening, yes. Some people will describe it as if you're suspended, crown of the head. Back of the knees are not locked, so you're mindful. You might engage the inner thigh, the outer thigh, the glutes a little bit more. So the heart's lifted, you feel the shoulder blades gently gliding down the back of the rib cage. Good, as you keep the heart open. In through the nose, out through the nose. When you're ready, lift the face up towards the heavens. Exhale those shoulder blades down the back of the rib cage and gently begin to circle the skull around. Yes, now I'm remembering last time I saw one of you, we talked about the extension of the neck in the back plane, so you want to be very mindful. And when you're ready, we take that around oppositional. Good. Opposite way, excuse me. And head's going to come to center. Gently tilt the skull to your right. Let the left arm reach out and extend. Deeper stretch. Left side of the neck. Movement as you need to, and then on back, head up and over now to the left, and good. Right arm is going to reach. And arm back, and head back, sweep up, inhale. Good, take that focus up. Once again, recognizing alignment, and full circle all the way. Good. Three more times. I'm just going to close that door. Inhale, stretch up, reach up. And pause at the top and exhale. In. And two more times. Wherever you are. Good. And stretch. Inhale. Very nice. Feel your side body lengthening. And last time. Sweep inhale up. Very nice. Right arm's just going to cross. Check on in. So again, your yoga experience can bring awareness to what your body's communicating to you. It's always your practice. Adjust as you need to. Good. So here again, you don't want to close those airways. You want to keep them open. And if you press the back of the head perhaps into that arm a little bit, it can help motivate that muscular connection, and then left arm is going to cross. So we've gone through the yamas. Today we're on the fifth niyama, which is Ishvara Pranidhana, and an easy way of translating the Sanskrit is let go, let God. That's an expression that often people will use when they're in challenges. We'll shift over into that left thigh and find external rotation with that right. But we want to hold on to the stability through the pelvis, through the heart. We're isolating in that rotation. Perhaps we just stay. We're reaching out through the heel. And then when you're ready, switch to the other side. Challenge the balance. And find that rotation. And let's gently find side, body, interlace fingers, flip the palms on up, inhale, take it on over. So stabilize the legs, good. So we're working from the inside of the pelvis if you're able. And inhale, center, and exhale over. Some techniques will bring the legs completely together. And some people, let's take that one more time, inhale through center. And some people will prefer that, but it really changes the dynamics of what you experience. And we'll explore that later. Inhale and exhale. Good. Let's lift the heart and swan dive. Feel the extension and bend the thighs. Take it over neutral. Right here. Hollow that belly. Let the head relax, the jaw relax. And then when you're ready, just bend into the thighs. Take your time and make your way onto seated position. Whether or not you're using mats to use an extra little cushion, you feel free. Good. And you can feel free to open up those joints as well. You listen? Good. So now we've taken the tilt through the skull. We set up that same internal connection, yes, through the body. We find the shoulder blades down, and then we take that head as far to the right as you're able. Once again, maybe you find movement. Breath serves. And through center, and to the left. Center it up, six movements of the spine, interlace. We lift the heart here. Inhale, hollow, up and over that space, posterior tilt. Good, just like we do in cardio dance. And inhale, if you're in that class, but it's a posterior tilt. Post anterior tilt or neutral. Inhale, hollow, good. Use that breath. Being dynamic with your jaw, breath in through the nose, out through the nose, but now we're in a different space, so if you need to be audible with your exhalation, feel free, it's okay, but in a close proximity, we're mindful, good, hands release, and side body, take it on over, good, let's continue to move, good, inhale, we lift the heart, reach that arm in space, exhale, mid-plank, open the twist. Now you can apply a deeper exhalation if you prefer with that. Again, not mandatory. That's where your practice comes into positioning as you align yourself with your practice, with your needs at the moment. And inhale. Good. And exhale. Now move back into your side body. Awareness into that wrist. Maybe the rotation changes the information through the shoulder. And meet up at top, inhale here. Take it on over, set on up, sense the shoulder blades and we move. Inhale, heart lifts and exhale, reach. Inhale, exhale. Good, two more times. Good, let's meet back side body. Remember that wrist might shift. And let's meet up top, very nice. Lift the heart here, create length through the core muscles, take that twist, set on up. And then once you're organized here, feel the shoulder blades down, the heart's lifted. And we take the skull or the focus or the head over that left shoulder. For some of us, cues us to drop that shoulder down a little bit more. Again, it's your experience. And through the nose, out through the nose. And meet at top, very nice. Inhale, stretch up, reach up. Good, keep that length, take that twist, set on up. Once you get organized, now you're gonna take that skull focus over that right shoulder.
we're just
adding a little twist on top of alignment. Feel the breath moving in your body. Meet at top, inhale, very nice. Stretch up, reach up. Now we go into a deeper heart opening posture here. Find the front body strong. Open those arms as wide as you need to. Find your fingertips as we go into a deeper opening of the heart. As we open to health, we open to wellness, we open to guidance, and we open to Ishvara Pranayama. The skill to be able to let go of that which does not serve us. The skill to be able to not become emotionally attached to things that are not of concern to our well-being. Feel the breath move through the front body. And then walk it on forward, very nice. Thighs open on up, find the extension. Ah, yes, yeah, shake it out. Yes, now if you've been jumping around, again, you listen, you might need to just completely relax, you might need to press. And then we go gently into the movement of the feet, but with Dandasana, we still set up those gateways, the bandhas, mula bandha, root, lock. We're lifting to the pelvic floor, uriyana bandha, finding strong through the solar plexus, jalandhara bandha, through the throat, the neck. Good, you listen to your body's communicating. We find the heel, the ball, the toe, heel, or the flex, the floint, and the flex, open. Good. Now, we're just going to gently find a pivot at the hip, and for those of you who want to grab a towel and use the assistance of the towel, you can. You're mindful, as we're taking this pivot, you are engaging the low core, low abdomen. Sideways for demonstration. We're going to come on our backs and work our legs. Again, just with gravity. First, we're going to find extension. I'm going to show this to you before we get into it. We're going to open the thighs. Now, when we do, I want you to really work the thighs into that external rotation. We'll find this bending motion for a few times. Then we'll work one leg. The arms will be wide to help. And we'll come back up. And we'll go alternating to the sides. So let's come center, and I will cue this as we continue to go through it. Come on down to your back supine. Open up those arms now if it's going to be helpful for you. Both legs externally rotate, and we bend nice and easy into the thighs. I really want you to open through those hips and inhale, extend. Traditional breath, exhale, flexion. And inhale, extension. And remember, you're listening to your body as we're moving, and if your body communicates that something is not feeling appropriate, then you know to back off. And just one more time, using the breath. Now, that right leg is going to open to the right as that left heel bends. So you really want to take your time, use those arms, control that right leg back on up to alternate, and left leg opens. Try not to let go of the muscle groups. Nice, fluid, gentle movement. One movement, one breath often you'll hear. The ujjayi breath, intentional use of the breath. And one more, opening to that right side, feeling the sensation that your body's communicating. And then, left leg. Now we're just going to counterpose into Supta Balasana or supine child, knees bent. Hands on the knees and they draw into the shoulders. You're aware, pelvis is neutral. Maybe you need to wiggle a little bit here. Maybe you need to rock. This is a nice little resetting through the lumbar sacral area. And then you're gonna roll to one side or the other, make your way on up to neutral spine or tabletop, as you'll hear it also expressed. Good, you're mindful. Good, hands are open and wide. Gently you stack through the bones. The wrists are right under the shoulders, the knees are right under the hips. Now, I want you to find a sensation here intentional. You're gonna press the tops of the feet here into the mat. You're gonna press the mat away without locking the elbows and engage through the core muscles. So just feel that sensation in the body and then release that and then just come to the form or the shape. And then one more time, press tops of the feet. Press the mat away, feel the muscles engage, the navel, the spine, shoulder blades are down the back. Do you feel the difference?
Good.
And then let's release and come on up to the knees.
Good. So when you come to that particular, good, and just give a little bit of wrist therapy here because we're going to be on the wrist here, getting some heat one direction, and then we can separate, create space. So that's an option for you, again, whenever you come into tabletop to engage like this. And now we're gonna flow here. Right ball of the foot comes to the mat, calf, Achilles stretch, that leg lifts, hip level. Left arm sends forward, mindful your right elbow's not locked. We inhale, hollow that belly, find the twist, thigh and knee. Thigh and up. Good. Hollow exhale. Inhale, exhale. Good. Intentional use of the breath. One more. Inhale, extension. Exhale, flexion. Send it out into the balance, front and back or open to the side. Shift maybe your center of gravity. Breath serves. Right elbow's unlocked. Arm back, leg back, hand back, knee back. Same thing now, feel the heat getting in the body. It's all intentional. And left leg lifts hip level. Right arm sends, inhale and hollow. Cross the elbow, inhale, exhale. Inhale, stretch, exhale. Inhale, in. Out into the balance, front and back, or arm and leg can open to a slight diagonal. And then again, shift gently that center of gravity forward if you wish. And arm back, leg back, hand back, knee back. Knees wide now, pose of the child. Hips go back, and find the arms reaching. So again, with the arms forward, this is extended pose of the child. The arms can become very active here, jaws easy, but we're intentionally breathing into our back body, our side body. Using Ujjayi, uplifting victorious breath. Take it over to your right side, soften, reach that left arm. The left and reach that right arm. Soften. Use the breath as a tool. Creating volume in the body, creating space in between muscle groups. Back to
practice center for a little twist coming on up. So we're all set up. We keep the knees wide, toes towards one another. Center the left arm and place that right arm where it is comfortable for you. Right hand on the hip and inhale, stretch.
And exhale, take that twist. Now as we twist, remember, engage shoulder blades down in your spine. We inhale to the mat. We exhale, shoulder blades, left elbows unlocked. Two more times. Inhale, twist. Exhale through that upper back, thoracic area, and inhale. Shoulder girdle area. Switch to the other side.
Set on up, and we inhale, center, and shoulder blades down. Exhale, twist. Now right elbow remains unlocked, and moving with your breath. And inhale. And exhale. And
now, I want to go through this explanation again for awareness. Now, as you find the muscle groups along the side of the neck, they originate in the occipital lobe of the skull, and they run down and through and attach to the collarbones. So the extension muscles, right? But you know where I'm talking about, though. But this is those are the groups that are created for the extension. So I want to go through this explanation so that we know we're not dropping and releasing that. We want to strengthen that connection. So that is where we are taking certified masseter. Yes. We bend, we come into the cactus right here, and you'll find a focal point. Yes, that's the idea, that's the idea. Good. Now, come on back to center. Good. So first we're going to go side body back and forth, and then we're going to come into that cactus. And notice how we take our center of gravity ever so slightly in the back plane. So our glutes are working, everything is working. Good. So first side body. And don't worry, there's no testing here. Inhale. And exhale over. And inhale, and exhale, and again. So notice our upper body's moving, so we're really having to stabilize through the low body, through the glutes, through the thighs. Good. Engage those core muscles, navel to spine. Inhale, center. And exhale. Good. Now we're just going to find, very nice, three times in our cactus. We inhale. Exhale. Now really lift through the heart. Engage through the front side, back core muscles, center of gravity. We come right back up. Good. So go only as far as you are ready. Inhale. And slide back plane. Lift the heart. Feel the oppositional energy. And know that you're not pinching in the back lumbar. Inhale. Exhale. Lift and extend. And inhale, up, very nice, good. Circle those arms. Now we're gonna stretch, counter pose. Now we're gonna stretch into the glutes, into the hamstrings, with downward facing dog. Set on up, remember that sensation we set up here earlier? You really feel the mat. You feel the motivational, muscular energy. Now, balls of the feet to the mat, float the hips up and down dog. Again, the strength of the back. Imagine someone is helping you, assisting your hips to the back wall with the back and the arms, but you're not bowing through the spine. You're looking at your toes. You're closing your ribs. You're creating front strong body. Now, take the feet back about 3 inches, and we're gonna roll through the spine. Be mindful. We're gonna lift the heels, posterior tilt,
length, find your focal point, try not to drop the hips too much, and take that right back up. Let it initiate from low core. Inhale. Find your plank, inner thigh, outer thigh, activate glutes. And right from the center back on up. And gently knees come to the mat. And lower onto the forearms. Check on them. So again, we activate through the shoulder girdle. And if you did abdominal work yesterday, you might be feeling this stretch. Good, so the shoulder blades are down and you're floating the heart forward, keeping the navel, the spine though, ensuring good that the lumbar is not compressed. Now, just the posterior tilt of the pelvis, float the hips up, find that tilt, and then if you want to go into swing, so plank on the forearm, float into straight leg. Inner thigh, outer thigh, glutes. Awareness into the breath. Awareness into the body working as a whole. Breath is serving. Gently bring the knees to the mat. Wrap through the core. And then finally find your full body stretch. Find the fingertips. Or spider hands. Again, allow that breath to soften. Allow that breath to counterpose the action that you just created. Same thing. Walk over to your right. Reach that left arm. Ujjayi breath. Jawsy. Through center and over to the left and reach that right arm. And center it up. We're going to roll on to our left side and first find a quad stretch or not. You're mindful with your knees. And this particular little pattern of movement is going to show itself again. So we roll to the left side. You draw the right knee on up. The right hand goes on the knee. Now this slides down to the ankle or to the foot somewhere. And you stack the knees. So let the hand travel on that foot as you need to, as you draw the right heel in towards the right glute. Again, you're mindful of a neutral pelvis. The jaw is easy. Intentional use of the breath. Fluid in through the nose and out through the nose. Take your time, just gently release that foot. Roll onto the right side, adjust as you need to. And draw that left knee on up. Left hand goes on the knee, it slides to the foot. Adjust with that hand. And we stack the knees. Quad stretch here. Neutral pelvis and breath is serving. And release that. Let's come back to our prone, back to our tummies, and find our hover. So this is where we're focusing on core, navel to spine, and we just barely float the limbs off for now. Let that breath continue to strengthen through the front side back core muscles. Jaws easy. And then we're going to add our swimming, alternating right arm, left leg, inhale and exhale, hover and inhale, left arm, right leg, back and forth.
course. Take your time, remember. Just listen to your breath, to your movement, and let them work synergistically. Let them work in tandem, supporting one another. Wherever you are, finishing it off, left arm, right leg, and then check in. Release the muscle groups. Maybe you need to wiggle somewhere. And then addressing the upper back, strengthening with swan. Find the forearm into the mat. Again, this is where we stabilize the low body. Pressing the thighs, the hips, tops of the feet, the toenails, as much as you wish, engaging through the quads. Shoulder blades are down, neck is long, elbows hug. Exhale, float the heart, float the forearm off, create length in the body. And once again, let that breath continue to serve. Ujjayi, stronger intentional diaphragmatic breath. And lengthen. Now we're going to find a little bit more flexion in the spine, intimidating cobra. The arms are just going to go out to a diagonal. Good. Same idea, the low body grounds, the shoulder blades down. Exhale. Press, float the heart, find that flexion through the spine, but then once you've reached your maximum, really draw the shoulder blades down the back of the rib cage so that you really feel the back shoulder girdle area working. Encourage the breath. Feel the extension through the legs. The neck long, the navel, the spine, elbows not locked. And lengthen back to the mat. Now one last back extension. We're going to find our full locust or salambasana. This is bringing a lot of blood flow to bladder, to prostate. Sweep the arms around. Rotate the palms up to the heavens. Exhale, float the limbs off. Now again, once you reach your maximum, let the diaphragm continue to move. Let that inhale create volume and exhale soften. Use the breath. Mindful if you're exhaling out through the mouth with drying of that mouth. One more breath. And let's counter pose, low cobra. Legs come back together, hands either side of the heart, shoulder blades, elbows. Activate, stabilize low body. Press into the mat, low cobra. And then press bigger, bend round, walk wide knees. Toes towards one another, we counter pose. Inhale, dome. Exhale, hips to heels, and find one full inhalation, one full exhalation. Make our way to Anjaneyasana or Crescent Moon. Right leg will be forward. Everybody okay? We're going to find a little flow here. Now for those of you who have extra mats, you might want to use them for a little bit more height when we come to the flow, and I'll tell you when we get there. So first we find the right leg forward. You might engage the posterior tilt here and take the hips forward. So crescent moon, we lift the heart, we reach the arms. So once again, similar as we found the action of pressing the limbs in tabletop, you can engage that left shin, that left foot, a little bit more into the mat if it helps for stability. And then we make our way to the mat. So you're mindful, and we find the extension, left ball of the foot, and runner's lunge. Good. Front knee's not compromised at all. And if you want to use that mat for an extra little cushion, you do. Somewhere under the knee, maybe even two. Not compromised. Now we're going to stay right here. You can release that foot if it's helpful. Ball of the foot. And we're going to lower, adjust with your arms. We're going to lift the heart here. So again, you're getting a strong stretch. Then you exhale, shift the hips back, straighten through the right leg. One more time. Now this is a flow that you can maintain the knee down. Strong stretch, heart lifts here, and then exhale back. Now, I'm going to take it into a little bit deeper of a challenge where we bring it from the full runner's lunge and come into Parsvottanasana. So we lower the hips, we lift the heart here, it's a challenge, and then exhale, straighten that front leg, maybe you need to walk it in, and then one more time. Fingertips graze, we lift the heart, and then exhale. Good. Parsvottanasana. Good. Walk that back leg in. If you need to rotate it, but keep the hips. So we're coming into pyramid. Now, adjust and come into the right hamstring stretch, just like you were doing. So we straighten the good. Try not to lock it. Remember, if you engage those quads, that helps not to lock the back of the knee. And then we're going to put all of that on the other side. And left leg forward. Take your time. Be mindful again with everything your body's communicating to you. We find the posterior tilt of the pelvis slightly, if you wish. We take the shift of the center forward. Press into that thigh, awareness into the right shin, right foot. Maybe you're actively pressing it a little bit into the mat. Then we float the arms up, crescent moon, Anjaneyasana. Again, heart is lifted towards the heavens. It challenges the balance, engaging through the right glute if it helps. Lower body grounds, upper body continues to reach for the heavens. And then we float right on in to runner's lunge. So if you need to back off, you're mindful. Are you okay?
Yeah, it hurts, just a couple.
Okay, yeah, okay. Good. And then just a couple times here, you're going to shift forward, heart lifts, and take the hips back. So this is the motion from runner's lunge, heart lifts, and back. And then from your runner's lunge, same idea, runner's lunge, heart lifts, and take it back, pyramid, and one more time, good, heart lifts, shoulder blades, and
and then just straighten. Again, maybe you find a little external rotation with that right foot, pyramid, Parsvottanasana, or side flank, but really this gets strong into the hamstrings. And then we linger into the left hamstrings. Transition. Is everybody okay? So, we have another challenge with that same idea of balance and catching the foot. That same, find the knee, slide it to the foot. And then this will be our final challenge. we find a stretch of the hips. Right ball of the foot. Adjust with that left shin.
This is what I'm getting. You don't want the hips behind you. You want the hip under you. You start setting up your side body. Right arm, you move up to the heavens or by the ear. You can stay right here for side body. Checking into the alignment through the shoulder blades. Left elbow unlocked. A little bit more challenging. That right leg floats on up. More challenging. Round the spine. Let that right hand, just like we did earlier, find that right knee. Slide it to the ankle and open up into a variation of sugar cane in the moonlight. Breath serves. You've got the towels. I like to come up, make sure that hip stays under. Keep that hip under, find the mat. Left arm to the heavens, you can stay here, or bring it by the ear, stay here. Or challenge, lifting that leg hip level, stay here. Or challenge, round the spine, left hand to left knee, slide it to the ankle, to the foot, open up. Variation, sugar cane. One arm, one leg, nice and easy. Bend the elbow, bend the knee, and move on. Now, deer pose. Good. Open up that right good thigh. And let the left swing in back of you as you're able. Now, if this left, good, but both hip bones will stay straight on. Now, if that left thigh doesn't want to cooperate, adjust where it's going to work for you. Ideally, this is spastika. So it's important to put that accent, stika, because this is actually a positioning of higher being. We rotate to the right thigh. Good, just and relax here. Excellent. So this is just a nice gentle stretch in your right hip or maybe somewhere else. Jaw, let the head go, or maybe you rest your cheek on the knee. Once again, letting go. The highest good, the highest good for you. Recognizing the higher self. Take your time, pressing into the mat, and you're just going to lean on to that. Swivel the legs around, other direction, you're mindful. Hips will be square as you're able, good. Just rotating to the left, taking your time, locking it down. Again, settling into it. Let that exhalation take you into the stretch, good. Take your time, gently pressing, and then just lean. Let's make our way onto our backs. Roll it on down. So this is just a Pilates method. Good, so we're still engaging.
Good. Walk it on down and the knees come in. This is your counter pose. You check in. Now you're staying there as I finish with the camera. And find one last stretch. Palms together until the loop. Namaste. Good. And then we're going to find seaweed. Your legs are going to float up. Arms float up and we find a little inversion.